Colin Cowgill and Anton DeJesus aren't simply just former teammates who try and stay in contact with each other whenever they get a chance. The two have formed a relationship most of us work a lifetime for. Cowgill and DeJesus aren't just normal friends either, but also two of the greatest outfielders ever to play for the University of Kentucky. The most common understanding the two have is the dream to play, and not just play professional baseball, they already do that, but to make it to the show. You know, where you hit white balls for batting practice. Ballparks are like cathedrals, the hotels all have room service, the women all have long legs and brains. But if the two really want to make it, and I mean really make it, the battle begins now. It's the offseason. It's where a player's real improvement begins.
Being a freshman coming into Kentucky, a lot of people don't get the chance to start, and Anton was one of the guys that came in as a freshman and just had it figured out before he stepped in. He played for a pretty unbelievable summer team, the Midland Redskins, one of the best high school summer programs in the country. They were World Series champions that year, and he had already figured out that, you know, he knew what he had to do to come in and get some quality playing time. He already had it figured out before he got in, and that's tough to do, especially in the Southeastern Conference. You know, that's probably the best baseball conference in the country, and for a guy that's so young and so raw, as Anton to come in and have that kind of success, it's just really credit to what he did before he got there. From the start, we became like real good friends, and we were next door neighbors in the dorms, and just knew right off the bat that we were going to be good friends.
The thing that's really impressed me the most about Colin is really is just his determination and will just to get better. I think he is the career leader in home runs in Kentucky, but he came to UK, and I know Coach Cohen really didn't expect much out of him, but Colin's really the hardest worker I think I've ever been around. I've learned from Colin that, you know, no matter what anybody says, just as long as you work hard, I mean, you can do whatever you want.
Well, I'd say college was easy compared to pro ball, just because if you didn't perform in college, you're just gonna get benched, and that was it. I mean, you went 0-4, you may not be in the lineup the next day. And pro ball, man, you go 0-4, you know, you have a week where you go 0-20, and that happens all the time. You can just get fired. I mean, it's such a, the turnover in pro baseball is so much higher than anything else. Like you can have a rough spot and they just get rid of you. So it's, there's a lot of added pressure, but at the same time, I guess you kind of embrace it because you are making money doing it. So it's what you've wanted to do. I mean, in college, you wanted money. You wanted to get an extra job because you had to pay for the things that you needed there, but now in pro ball, you know, you're getting paid to do it, so it makes it a little easier, but at the same time, like I said, there is a little bit more added pressure just because, you know, if you don't, just like anything else, any other job, if you don't perform well, they won't keep you around, so I don't know if that's a setup.
Yeah, I mean, it's the same thing, like he said, if you don't perform, you know, you're not going to play, and for me, it was tough. I got started actually late this past season because I had surgery on my wrist, so I got in late, and so it was even more pressure on me. If I didn't perform, then I really wasn't going to play, you know, because I already got off to a late start, and it's tough. I mean, and now you really start to think that, yeah, this is a job, because, you know, there's a lot of pressure that goes on with it. And, I mean, it's not as easy, and it's not as, you know, great as a lot of people think it is. And, oh, you live the easy life, you know, and it's tough. I mean, it's a grind, and more than anything, I'd say it's more of a mental grind.
From what I understand, you all are pretty big gamers, and that FIFA is what you all play, while soccer is kind of an interesting choice. Who do you think is better at that?
He's definitely better at FIFA, you know. We used to have, everybody had the Xbox 360 and like the PlayStation, and then we had the PS2, man. We had the FIFA 05 or something when it's 2007.
We had it gone for a while.
We'd battle, man.
We'd always get like four or five.
Four people playing on the same thing. We'd have teams, but I'd always try to get on his team because he was always busting me when we were playing. So
yeah, it's always just best to work together.
I know.
All right, on a more serious note, what has it been like, the journey to where you are now?
At the end of the day, I can't imagine doing anything else. I love going and, you know, getting in front of thousands of fans and, you know, playing and making great catches and, you know, just playing and winning games. And it's like nothing else.
It's definitely satisfying. There's nothing like, you know, you show up to the park every day and you don't have, you know, we're not wearing a suit. We don't have to sit in an office. I mean, our office is out there in the outfield.